From Vandenberg Air Force Base in California, this is Delta Launch Control at T-minus 1 hour, 40 minutes, 52 seconds and counting. That puts us slightly more than 2 hours away from the launch of the Orbiting Carbon Observatory 2 spacecraft, also called OCO-2. This is NASA's first mission dedicated to studying atmospheric carbon dioxide, the leading human-produced greenhouse gas driving changes in Earth's climate. OCO-2 will provide a new tool for understanding the human and natural sources of carbon dioxide emissions and the so-called natural sinks that absorb carbon dioxide and help control its buildup in the atmosphere. The observatory will measure the global geographic distribution of these sources and study their changes over time. The OCO-2 spacecraft's final circular polar orbit will be 438 nautical miles above the Earth at an inclination of 98.2 degrees. It will be circling the Earth every 99 minutes. OCO-2 will separate from the Delta II rocket 56 minutes 15 seconds after liftoff. At this time, preparations are underway for loading the Delta II rocket with liquid oxygen. The countdown activities began on schedule and have been proceeding normally. This will be the 152nd Delta II launch for United Launch Alliance and NASA's 51st on a Delta II. NASA's first Delta launch from Vandenberg Air Force Base was on October 2, 1966 for the TOSS-A mission. We'll be getting a weather briefing shortly. At this time, weather is still very favorable for a launch overnight. And we're not working any issues or concerns at this point in the launch countdown. At T-minus 1 hour, 38 minutes, 47 seconds and counting, this is Delta Launch Control.